Instructions, as I told you, instructions are the one that has the steps in it, has the steps in it to process the given data. Okay, that is what instructions. And the processing, next term is processing. Processing is, again I told you before itself, it is the conversion of data and data into an information. Information is nothing but output, and data is the raw material. Okay, so when it start processing as per the instruction written in the CPU. Okay, then next term is information. Information is the output of the complete process. Once the data is given, that is the raw material is given, and as per the instructions, the process starts inside the CPU, and whatever the output we get on the screen, that is nothing but information. Information has some meaning. Okay, information will have some meaning. Like if you take in the case of making a juice, or otherwise you take some mathematical problems, like for example 2 plus 3, 2 and 3 are data, and you will process it. Once it is processed, the last output information will be 5. 5 has some meaning, right? If you give 2 and just 2 and 3 without any meaning, there is no meaning to it. It can be 23, it can be 2 plus 3, it can be 2 into 3, 2 minus 3. Once, as per the instructions given, whether it needs to be added, whether it needs to be subtracted, when the instruction is given along with the data, then you will get a meaningful information. So data is meaningless and unorganized facts, and information is meaningful information. The processed data, you can see the definition for information, it is processed data. Okay, next term is storage. Once, as I gave you the example of storage, like when you create some files like presentations, when you create some Word files as assignment for exams and all, for your practical exams, you saved it, right? Whatever you created, you saved it. So that is what, whenever ma'am is not there, you will save it and go. When ma'am asks you again, you will open it and show. Okay, that is the use of storage, and you will save it on our hard disk. Hard disk is the one, it is a part of CPU that is used for storage purpose, right? That is what storage is. Next, user. User is a person who operates computer. You people are users when you come to computer lab. Okay, whoever operates the computer, they are called as user. Next is hardware. Hardware are the one, all the physical parts of our computer, whatever you can see and you can use, touch and use it, those we call it as hardware. The physical parts, okay, mechanical pieces, physical equipments, keyboard, mouse, monitor, speaker, scanner, printer, all these are hardware. Okay, next comes software. Software is the one which you can't touch. You can see it, but you can't touch. Okay, like it can be MS Office software, or it can be Windows operating system software, and it can be logo software, or it can be Tux Paint software. All these are the softwares which is developed by computer programmers. Computer programmers will write the code and they will develop the software. What do you mean by writing program? Program is nothing but they will write some instructions. They will tell the software, for example, I'll take Tux Paint. When you open Tux Paint, when you click on red color and you will take your paintbrush and you will click on red color and you will draw it on your workspace, but it comes in green. Is the given instruction right? No. So all these instructions will be written by the programmers who develops, who creates that particular software. He will be writing in his instructions, like whenever a user comes and touches on red color box, when he takes your paintbrush to the workspace, it should come in red color itself. And he whenever the person users touches on some flower, that flower should be present on your workspace. So all these are different instructions, how the software should work. These things will be done by a computer programmer. Okay, then he creates a complete software. Then we will install it in our computer. No, for the proper working of computer, not only works with its hardware parts, right, switch, mouse, keyboard, but it needs some softwares also to work it properly. Softwares only can give instructions to the hardwares to work properly. Okay, that is what the software is. Next is network. Network is when many computers connected together. The best example is our computer lab. In our computer lab, you can see all the computers are connected to each other. Even teachers can see the files, whatever you saved in your computer. Somewhat I say you are sitting in 39th computer, 39 number computer at the window side. If you save something there, we can sit on the teacher's computer and teacher can see whatever you are saving. That is only because all the computers inside the lab is been connected together. It is on the network. It is also called as LAN, okay, local area network. Don't go for that difficult term, let it be a network. So once a computers are on a network, then we can share the resources inside that. You are saving in that computer, but we are able to open in some teacher's computer. That means sharing, no? You are giving your file saved in that computer to our computer. That is nothing but sharing. So that is what the network is. When the computer is connected together, and it helps us to share the resources. And also, once the computer is connected together, we can use it to print. If the software, right software is installed in all the computers in our lab, sitting at some particular, let me tell you, 10th computer near that cupboard, right? Some 10th computer, if we have installed the printer software, sitting there itself, I can give print. Printer is on the teacher's table, the print can be given to that printer also, even if we won't connect it with wired. Okay, even if we won't connect it physically, once it is networked, we can give print from there itself. So that is what the sharing of hardware, printer became hardware and we are sharing it. So once the computer is connected together and we are sharing the resources, hardware, software, and also data and information, that becomes network. Okay, next term is internet. Internet is a big network around the world. Just think of a fish mesh. When people do fishing, they will use fishing net, right? That if you see that each thread is being connected together with the knot, right? Just consider that each knot as a computer. Just imagine a fishing net and each knot as a computer, and that complete net is surrounded our globe. So how do it look? Complete net is surrounded by a globe. That is what the internet is. When I was talking about network, I talked about our computer lab network, right? There we have only 40 computers which we have connected. There we have a small net, right? But you just imagine a big net with all the people around, how many millions of people they are using the computer with the internet in their computers, and they are